What's good on YouTube? This is Crazy Sarah, so I'm here bringing you another video. Today I'm bringing you a video on the Power Rangers movie 2017 spoilers review. Keep that in mind, it is a spoilers review, so for those of you that are interested in seeing my non-spoilers review, you should look at the link above, or go back a few seconds and click on the link towards the top. That will bring you to that, or it might be in the side, and I might also put it in the description. For those that are interested in seeing my spoilers review, for seeing my non-spoilers review, keeping in mind that some of you may or may not have actually seen the movie yet, so just be aware of that. If you're wondering, is it a good movie? Is it a bad movie? If you want to know from a non-spoilers perspective, definitely view it from that perspective now, because otherwise I'm going to be doing spoilers. But anyway, yeah, just wanted to make you aware. So I'm gonna give you guys like probably 2 or 3 seconds, probably 5 seconds. So up to you. So anyway, I wanted to now go into this review. Obviously, for those that do not know, this has been something I've been waiting for over 2.5 years probably now. The movie was announced back in, I would say, August of 2014 during Power Morphicon, which is a major convention related to the Power Rangers franchise, which happens twice, like once every 2 years. So that's typically what has happened. They just had one last year, and that was the 5th Power Morphicon. So yes, they've been doing this for quite some time now. And I'm sure that 2018 will have its own Power Morphicon as well. obviously now it's March 2017, as I said before, which means that a lot of time has gone by. I've been covering it, posting all sorts of videos for the past 2.5 years about it, all sorts of developments, the whole timeline of events that have been occurring over time. Just in general, it's been a lot of fun and it's been a lot of stuff, but we're finally at this movie, and doesn't mean that the Avengers is over, because supposedly there might be sequels that might be coming out in the future. Do I expect that to happen in the next like year? Probably not. More likely 2 years or so that I would imagine us seeing a sequel. But I don't want to say anything until I know for a fact. Anyway, I wanted to talk to you guys about this movie. The Power Rangers movie 2017, I personally liked a lot. I thought it was a really fun movie. There were things that I wish would have been done differently. Overall, I think that there was a lot of really cool stuff. I liked the fact that they did have an origin story a little bit. Sure, it wasn't much of an origin story. You know, there was a bit of origin, but it really wasn't like a lot. It was nice to see Zordon as the Red Ranger, and see Rita as the female Green Ranger, and see the Yellow Ranger, but see that they all were aliens, which was very cool to see how they designed them. They also spoke in a unique language that apparently the three of them, Bill Hader, who played Alpha 5, Bryan Cranston, who played Zordon, and Elizabeth Banks, who played Rita, had to learn, and it was a made-up language that they created that was such an unusual thing that apparently the only one of the three of them that actually ended up like mastering the language was Elizabeth Banks. Apparently Bryan Cranston probably had the worst time learning the language, and then it was probably Bill Hader. But Elizabeth Banks apparently was really good at the language, so that's interesting. As far as other things go, it was cool to see how, you know, that whole element of the story went on. It would have been nice, personally, though, if they had chosen to actually explain how she became evil. That's one of the things that I feel like that origin story kind of lacked, was the explanation. It was sort of assumed that, you know, Zordon had failed to be a good leader and all that, but it wasn't very much so clear as to what led her to turn evil. You know, The general thought is that supposedly Lord Zedd had gotten to her, but there's not enough, but nothing has been like said specifically as to whether or not that is a fact, but that's what people are kind of assuming. As far as other things go, I really did like the Rangers, each one of them. I think that, as far as which one I actually like the most, that's a really hard one. I think that each one of them had really great things that made them stand out in their own ways. I like Dacre Montgomery's character for Jason. I thought that he had an interesting background story. I liked the fact that each of them had their own real problems, because obviously the original show didn't go that way. The original show had them all being goody-two-shoes kids rather than being normal kids that had problems and stuff. And I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying these problems were like, you know, your typical everyday problems. These were like pretty, like crazy, like insane problems that, you know, happen to people occasionally, but aren't something that like you would find five kids meeting up and necessarily having all these problems and having to kind of connect over the struggles that they faced. And it's just very interesting to think that they decided to do it in that way. Because, I mean, think about it. You know, you have Dacre Montgomery, who was like this athlete who, you know, ruined his career. You have Naomi Scott, who ruined her ability to make friends in school. You have, but was like this completely popular girl at one point. And then you have, Ludi Lin, who, Naomi Scott was Kimberly, and then you have Ludi Lin, who played Zach, who was, you know, having to take care of his mother and was fearing for his life because he was concerned with her dying because of her illness. And, you know, Billy being a kid of the autism spectrum and having to not have a father that like he cared for more than anything else. And, you know, Becky being the constantly new kid who suffered to make friends and had trouble dealing with understanding herself as a person and what and who she affiliated with, gender, like, sexually. I mean, it's a pretty different story. It's definitely not our original Mighty Morphin Power Rangers by any means of the word. And I found that pretty crazy, you know? I really enjoyed the fact that they made it so different and they gave them these bigger than life problems that, you know, seem so troublesome and seem so crazy, but at the same time, real. Like, these are real problems. These are real things that happen to people. And I just found that, you know, it made them feel more real. It made them feel like these weren't just, you know, your average kids that you just kind of see. You know, these were your kids that had trouble, who struggled in life, who had to somehow, like, they ended up meeting each other and this became their way, their sanctuary, the thing that kept them sane. You know, I mean, Naomi Scott's character who played Kimberly, she wanted to kill herself. Most of them were really troubled. I mean, these were troubled kids. And it was just like this whole entire idea of them finding a sanctuary and being around each other and being able to express themselves and become friends and learn to trust one another. I mean, it's such a different story. At the same time, it was very cool. There were so many like nice little references that were done well because, you know, it wasn't a movie where they were doing things in a way where the references you had to were like, there were references, but most of the references weren't ones that you necessarily, like, if you didn't know it, it would affect your knowledge of the story. You would still be able to get by, it's just it would be that much harder for you to understand what's going on. You know, like, for me, I feel, like, one of the references that I really love that they had was the fact that when Dacre Montgomery's father, Sam Scott, who was played by David Denman, was trying to find Jason during the whole entire attack from Goldar, you know, he mentions I'm between Mariner Bay and Reefside. And the reason why that's kind of clever is because, for those who don't know, Mariner Bay refers to, obviously, Power Rangers Lightspeed Rescue, the base that they stayed in, Reefside refers to, I believe, Dino Thunder. So that's actually very cool to see that they decided to reference two different seasons. One's Dino Thunder, which is a Disney season, and one's Lightspeed, which is a Saban era season, but late Saban, and a pretty interesting one. So pretty cool. I actually really, really appreciated that. Obviously, there was also the one for, like, you know, Alpha saying I, and Rita saying make my monster grow, which was very cool. Obviously, she didn't say make a magic wand make my monster grow, but she did say make my monster grow, which I appreciate that they did have that kind of in there. So that was smart. They did do that. As far as, like, items and stuff like that, there really wasn't any items or anything along those lines that were noteworthy that you actually saw necessarily. It wasn't like there was an item that was hanging around that referenced some season. Not that I really think there was anything, but, that was something. There was also death, technically, in this movie, which was pretty interesting to see. I mean, you know, seeing death in the middle of the movie, and then sort of seeing almost like a reference to that power transfer aspect of the show that people kind of assumed would never happen in this movie, but kind of was referenced in a way, because it was sort of like, you know, there could only be one red that could exist at a time, and that's sort of what was implied in this movie at one point, which I really think was kind of clever. Another thing was these words, and the Rangers themselves. I as far as like how I feel about how much use we got out of the Ranger suits and everything, I don't mind that we didn't get too much. I think that in this case it actually worked, because the focus more or less so was on introducing these characters and getting people to know who they were and why do we care about them, you know, getting us to really understand their background. And I think that was what was really essential here, knowing who they were, knowing all that. And, you know, the suit, you know, and being able to gain that trust and understanding between each other to the point that they can go from just being, you know, random strangers that just kind of came across these power coins to becoming friends and respect, and being able to respect each other and having trust with each other, and developing bonds that allow them to become Rangers. I think that was such an interesting and important point, because, you know, they could have just had more fighting and more stuff like that, but they didn't. And I think that that's great. I think that, you know, by creating a story like they did, it definitely changes things up and makes things, you know, unique and interesting and very informative, and makes you want to see what they'll do. And, you know, the Zords, obviously, again, weren't used too much, but definitely had some use. What was interesting as well, obviously, was the Krispy Kreme thing, you know, having that be where the Zeo crystal was. That was something that was very different. Obviously, the Zeo crystal is something from Power Rangers Zeo, which is why it's sort of like one of the things that a lot of people kind of were confused about initially as to why they decided to have that in this movie, even though, you know, Zeo, this is not Zeo. But at the same time, what I kind of feel like it's implying is that, you know, future movie, is that there will be, if they do a future movie, like, they might go all the way to Zio at some point. Not necessarily implying that they'll do it, like, you know, at movie 2 or something like that, but I definitely feel like we'll get something if they do a bunch of these movies. You know, like the supposed rumors that they might be doing like 6 or 7 of these movies or so. If that is the case, then Zio definitely is a possibility, and would be very interesting to see how that would go over. As far as other things go, there was a cameo, which was very cool, towards the very end of the movie with Amy Jo Johnson, the original Pink Ranger, and Jason David Frank, the original Green Ranger. So that was very cool to see them appear. Their cameo didn't have any speaking lines, but it was more or less just them being part of a group of people looking up at the Megazord, which was very cool, very brief, but nice anyway. And I personally am glad to have seen that they were there. And people actually, when I was in the movie theater, were very, like, all sort of gabbing about, like, oh my god, that's so-and-so from the show. Yeah, like, a lot of people knew right away that they recognized it, and it was good. As far as other things go, great humor in a lot of cases. The movie definitely is something for adults and kids. There is cursing, though, so for those that don't know, again, there is cursing, so, you know, it's not like it's completely clean, but at the same time, it's not, you know, a filthy mess of language, and at the same time, you never hear, like, the F word, but you'll hear a lot of other words, plenty of times over, I'm just saying. As far as other things go, I did enjoy that they did include an after credit scene, as I did mention recently. The after credit scene was exactly what I've heard it was, which was that supposedly, you know, it was supposed to be detention and a teacher calling out Tommy Oliver and him not being there, which was basically what happened. More or less implying that if a sequel does occur, it will focus in on Tommy. Personally, if you're wondering what my opinion of that, of the sequel possibility is, I actually think that if they do it, I already have an idea of what they might do. For example, at the very end of the Power Rangers movie 2017, we end up seeing that Rita is launched into space, and what is shown behind her is the moon. Now, why is that important? Well, for those who don't remember from the original show, she was present on the moon throughout the whole show, and the reason why that's significant is because since she was present on the moon, what that meant was that the implication that I might be thinking of is that maybe she lands on the moon and creates her moon palace, and maybe the process she might meet Squat and Babu that may be living there, or maybe there might be some encounter with some astronauts on the moon where she'll attack them, referencing the first episode. That could be a possibility. I mean, those are definite possibilities. As far as the Green Ranger goes, will be interesting. One thing I will say that I did like, I wanted to mention, by the way, was the fact that I felt like when it came to the train accident, I didn't understand why, you know, like, suddenly that whole accident happened, they end up in their rooms. There's no implication as to why it happened. You know, you would assume the thing that kept them alive was probably their power coins, but how did they get back? Were they teleported or what? There wasn't any clear indication as to what it was. Same with when Zordon showed them Rita for the first time. You assume that he must have done something, but at the same time, there was no, like, force or mystical powers or anything showing that. It was just sort of like it was implied, which is why I kind of feel that it was one of those things that, you know, it would have been better to have made a little bit more clear rather than just kind of throwing us there and making it kind of just happen. I don't know. To me, that's what I kind of feel. I feel like those were some really annoying things. There were other things, but I think in a lot of cases, it was good. I think that the Moon Palace definitely is going to happen. I'm sure that more likely than not, though, they'll have the Green Ranger and he'll work under Rita. And something will happen between Tommy and Jason where they'll fight over Kimberly. And the reason why I say this is also because, like, Jason ends up kissing Kimberly. So, you know, it's kind of like that implication that, like, they're boyfriend and girlfriend. So maybe now it would be, like, this whole entire tension between the two of them. Because maybe, like, Kim would fall in love with Tommy. And then there would be this kind of spat between the two of them where it's sort of like, you know, does she stay with Jason or does she stay with Tommy? And it's just this uncertainty. You know, obviously there'll be some real story and reasoning behind why she'll switch over, but it sounds likely. Another point to mention is that it did seem like towards the later half of the movie that Sam Scott, Jason Scott's father, might have actually had some idea in his mind as to the fact that maybe, his son is the Red Ranger, but it's not set in stone as to whether or not that is going to be the case, but it kind of seemed like that might have been implied. Obviously, keep this in mind. I'm saying this to you now. It's very late. I actually saw this movie fairly late, and then I actually had to walk all the way back to where I am. In my college campus, and the thing is that the movie theater that I was at was actually quite far, and the buses that are usually operational were not operational when I came back, so I had to walk like 2 hours, which kind of sucked. So keep that in mind, that I'm also very tired. There were probably several other points that I could think of, but I'm just not remembering at this time because my mind isn't that fresh and good right now because I am just very tired. But, it will be very interesting to see how things will be expanded on. I'm sure that the second movie, if and when they'll do it, it will also tap into more background on Rita and how she became evil, hopefully going into Lord Zedd, and maybe showing how maybe he took over, how he made her evil and all that, because you would assume that, you know, they were on the same team. What could have led to her turning? Makes me very curious. Also, you have to keep in mind that, you know, she lived with Zordon and Alpha and the Yellow Ranger and their team 65 million years ago. So, you know, it's a very different thing. Overall, though, I really enjoy this movie. I'm exhausted right now. There are probably several other points that I might have been missing, but I would love to know your guys' opinions. What did you guys think of this movie? Did you enjoy it? Which Ranger did you resonate with the most? What did you think of this? What did you think of the villain? How did you like Zordon and Alpha? If so, what exactly did you enjoy? What do you think might be some of the ideas for the sequel to the movie? Do you think that any of the thoughts that I might have had are correct? If so, what? If not, what ideas do you have that might be possible future movie concepts that might occur? Also, do you have any ideas for what maybe the third or the fourth or the fifth or the sixth movie might be focused on? Whether it just be like a general idea or a larger, more detailed explanation. Also, just in general, what are your guys' thoughts on the movie? Did you enjoy it? Did you like it? What reference was your favorite? How did you see, when did you see the movie? Was it a fun time for you? I'd love to know all that and more in the comments below. Please remember to like, comment, subscribe. Check out my Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube, and Twitter. And also check out all my other videos I've been posting about the Power Rangers movie for the past, 2 years or so. I'd love to know what your guys' opinions on those are. And please remember to like, comment, subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. So until then, guys, I'm CrazySaurus21, and goodbye, guys.